Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if this is your first time joining us, thank you for watching. Okay, now today what we have is I went around in my local area and I found some vase containers or vase containers to put together my dry flower collection. And some of these guys you can these are very interesting containers that I found. And I bought these. These come from Ross, as you can see. I bought these at Ross. So I did, it took me a while to find a nice collection of vases in one place. So they are various prices from Ross. And be very careful when you're purchasing your containers to make your dried flowers, because you don't want anything to break or crack. Okay, and so as you can see over in this in here, I do have more selections over here. So what we're going to be doing together today, guys, is we're going to just be putting these flower arrangements together. And you can give these away as gifts, or you can just totally redecorate your house with all these wonderful, lovely flowers. So we're going to go ahead and get started and take these out of the package. And now we're going to be doing this together. So this is exactly how you would do it if you... Now here's some arrangements here that look nice together. I have more over here, and so we have all different types here, and we're going to actually put these together now that I have found the containers, because I purchased these first and then I had to go out and find the containers. So now that I have the containers, I'm going to go ahead and put this together. So, and then here's another container. This one, this one is the heavier one. I think I took the price tag off of that one already. So, okay, so we'll go ahead and get started. Okay, so yes, we're gonna go ahead and start taking these out of the wrappings and placing them in the containers. And so this is the, these are the lovely cotton plants that grow, and they're very pretty, guys. Take a look. Okay, so, and then here's another. I'm gonna put these two together. And now don't be concerned if as you're putting these together, you change your mind and want to rearrange again. So when you're doing more than one, okay, so I'm just cutting these out of the package, guys. So here's another one coming out of the package. So we're just trying to design these as we go and see which one is going to fit. Okay, so it's coming out. Just getting this unwrapped here. Okay. Just put that in here like that. That one going. And you can just kind of use your imagination and kind of try to figure out what goes with what. And, you know, it's really more fun than anything else. So don't let this stress you or anything. It's almost like putting together a piece of a puzzle, trying to get these figured out. Oh, look, this one has a lot of stuff coming out, so keep that in mind wherever you're placing this. This probably be okay after being out of the package for a couple of days. You just kind of shake that off. It's really coming out there. Just maybe even take it outside and give it a good shape. Now see, this one is kind of tall. So this is where when you purchase your arts and crafts tools, so you can snip these down when they're too long or too tall for you. So that's what we're gonna do. We'll grab the art tools and snip these down just to get them adjusted. Right now, you're just trying to figure out which ones are gonna look good together. So here's another type right here. Let's get this out and see how this one looks. Yeah, so just if you are even planning on doing the flower arrangements, make sure you do everything way in advance, guys, because you're actually gonna be needing to go on a treasure hunt for these. So okay, so in here we'll put these in here. Let's see, and then you can always change or rearrange. And you know what, this one is a really tall vase, so I think that one will fit in there better, and then that way we may not even have to trim that one down. Okay, and so you just think of what will go good with this, what will go good with this, what will go good with that, as you're looking at all of your other arrangements. So we have these right here are like little pumpkins, and they are in this color, which is like a natural color. And then here's some pumpkins in orange. Now, I understand, now for the pumpkins, if you want to hold on to those until the right season, you can, or you don't have to, because they're gonna look good no matter what you do. And these are cattails, guys. How many times have we seen cattails on the side of the road when you're traveling out on the road on the open highway? So let me get these open. You're gonna see these. I'm gonna open this up. Yeah, you're gonna see these all over the open highway, these cattails. You probably remember. But they're called cattails because they just bob and weave in the wind like a cat's tail does when they're playing. So fun. All right, so, and then these, let's see here. So you just kind of figure out what goes with what. Put it together. If you have like a certain color combination in your home, you can kind of go with that. Right now, I'm putting these together just so I can see what is actually gonna look good with what. So, you know, this can take a while, guys. And so basically, just go ahead and, you know, don't stress yourself. Just put these in there as you know. And this one is kind of short. I don't know what happened here. That's okay. You can even put that one in a different vase if you need to. So that one came. That's how that one came. It's kind of okay. And then here's some more. This is some wheat, guys. This is they got it pretty orange colored wheat. Let's get this package open and take a better look. And then once they get open and spread out, you know, they're going to be more pretty. But I wouldn't spread them out just yet. Just try to get them in some kind of order so that you can. So this is, see, that's pretty. Guys. Nice. Yeah, really nice on that one. Just the wheat and those little seeds. Okay. Now the pumpkins, I honestly love these pumpkins. but I would like to wait until the right time of year to present those pumpkins, because they're going to be so wonderful during the the holiday season when the pumpkins are out. So you can always hold on to the pumpkins and just put them in your vase anytime you get ready. So no pressure, guys, no pressure. And here's another one of those dry flowers. This is the pampas grass. It's a lot coming off of there. I don't know if you can see those little things coming off, but just take these outside on your lawn and just kind of give them a good shake, because they're gonna, you know what, they're gonna end up being really fluffy and hanging over. So right now they're standing up tall, but don't be surprised if eventually they, once they're not, because they were in the package, so once they get a little bit loose, they're gonna hang over perfectly. And they're beautiful now while they're standing up tall. Let's just, let me just see if you can see that. They're standing up tall right now, but they're gonna kind of lean over a little bit, just a little bit. Okay. All right. And I think we are almost, let's see. Okay, so let's put, we have over here, we have two of the cotton plants here and a cattail. I think those look really good together. And you can do different combinations, whatever you want, guys. And let's see. Okay, so here is like a natural color of the cattails. I think this color would look good with this color in this vase. And then, you know, you might even have to look at them for a couple of days before you decide. Yes, guys, before you decide to switch them around. So let's see what we have over here. We have, okay, so this is some more, this is wheat, and this is a, looks like a brownish color wheat. Let's see. Let's get this one open. Put this one somewhere. Okay. Yes, this is an earth tone wheat. I'm just gonna sift this in here for now with the cotton. And we move this one over. So be very careful with these, guys. Most normally, you would work with one at a time, but since I had purchased so many because I caught such a fantastic sale by default going in and out of stores, and so I just grabbed the, you have to grab what you see when you see it sometimes, because when you go back, it's not going to be there. And I'm telling you guys, I have gone back into the stores where I purchased these and they were not there anymore. So I'm so glad I didn't wait. So I found all the dried flowers all at once, and then I couldn't find any, this has an interesting wrapping around here. So these are kind of heavy. These are Milo seeds here. It's a little bit heavy. So they have these kind of intertwined there. So I'm going to leave this this wrapping on here just for now until I'm all done tinkering around with what's going to go where. So I think, because I know that these are going to end up opening up and falling over and being beautiful, I think I'm going to just leave these just as they are in this tall vase. And it's just going to be two different colors, and they're going to just fall over on each other beautifully. Okay, and then, so this is kind of a pretty combination with the burgundy and the orange there together. And then you have the cattails right here together. The cattails with these seeded plants. And so, let's see, guys. Let me just try something here. See how you're doing that? You're moving it around. So don't be in a big rush to get done with this project, because I'll put this in the back. Because you're going to have to move these around until you... There. Now that looks really good. I like that way that turned out there. And just kind of play around with the arrangements. Okay, and then this... These are also going to end up, once they're relaxed, they're going to end up leaning over a little bit. But right now, they're just standing up like this because they were in the package. And so this would actually go better in a shorter container like this. So, yeah, guys, just keep kind of working on it and working on it. And let's see here. I really like these... And you see how the cotton flowers have gotten some of the little... I'm going to have to take my blow dryer and just blow dry these off. This cotton kind of got some of the little tiny pieces on here from the other plant. And so now this is really basically it, guys. You just keep moving these around until you find the perfect combination of what you're trying to do. And just keep working on it and working on it. And these are really tall, so just kind of figure out exactly where you want to put the tall ones. And this is just an idea of how to get started. So you buy your vase containers. And then you find your flowers, find your beautiful little dry flowers. And don't worry if they match with something or not. Just if you see them, grab them. Because trust me, when you go back, most of the time, they're not going to be there. And that's it, guys. So, yeah, and hope you have lots of fun finding your containers and putting your flowers together. And just have fun, move them around, and then I'll kind of work on these a little bit longer and get the best positions in these containers, and then I'll add on a photo in the end here. Okay, guys, now go ahead and leave your comments, subscribe, like and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching, and you have yourself a great rest of your day.